Scientists think that the oldest rocks in Jezero crater formed from a thick lava flow or lava lake that once filled the crater. Now a very similar rock appears to have washed in from outside the crater, challenging that idea on this episode of Mars Guy. Perseverance is now exploring the top of a pile of deposits laid down by flowing rivers. Last month, it drove into a place that could be dubbed the Land of Odds for all the odd rocks lying around. There are some with shapes most easily described as weird, and others that are strangely familiar. Among them is a large wind-scoured boulder that's not really odd-looking, but it does seem oddly out of place. Here's Mars Guy for scale. This wasn't apparent until after the arm was deployed for the abrading operation needed to expose a relatively fresh patch of rock. Then the view with the arm-mounted Watson camera was stunning. And in this case, stunning not because it looks so different from previous rocks, but because it looks so remarkably similar to some. Of course, similar rocks are nothing to get excited about, but this one is part of an outcrop that Perseverance investigated nearly 2 years ago and more than 5 kilometers away. It's in a terrain unit dubbed Sita, Navajo for amongst the sand, that's long been recognized from orbital spectroscopy as being rich in olivine, a common volcanic mineral which was confirmed by Perseverance. The boulder on the fan has interesting prismatic glints, best displayed using the white LED lights of the Watson camera, which can be toggled to illuminate from the left side, right side, and together. This shows how different facets display a rainbow of colors depending on orientation. I've seen this same effect in olivine-rich rocks on Earth, like in this mantle xenolith, which is a chunk of Earth's mantle delivered to the surface by volcanic processes. Illuminating it from different angles really shows the prismatic effect. It's noteworthy that this effect is not evident in green olivine, like in this mantle xenolith. Apparently, the increased iron content in the brown olivine contributes to prismatic glints. That's consistent with what's already known about the composition of olivine in Sita. Observations by Perseverance led scientists to conclude that the olivine-rich rocks of Sita formed at the bottom of a lava flow at least 100 meters thick, or maybe even in a lava lake. But that's not a good explanation for the huge area of notably similar olivine-rich rocks outside Jezero crater, in the Neely Fosse region. There's no evidence for such thick lava flows there, and there's no basin to contain a huge lava lake, or even smaller basins for smaller lava lakes. The favorite explanation is that cataclysmic explosive volcanic eruptions produced olivine-rich ash deposits across the Neely Fosse region. So that brings us back to the big boulder that Perseverance is investigating. A straightforward explanation is that it washed into Jezero crater with raging floodwaters from the Neely Fosse region. That would mean that the olivine-rich rocks there are the same as the Sita rocks in Jezero crater, and that they all formed in the same way. But there's another explanation for how a Sita-like boulder got there. Maybe an asteroid impact into the Sita terrain flung pieces up onto the Jezero fan, like from this crater. But it's way too small to do that. Big chunks of rock like the one Perseverance is investigating typically only get lofted less than about 1 crater diameter away. A better option is that there's Sita-like terrain underneath the fan, and that the impact that made Belva crater penetrated into this terrain and threw out some chunks. The only way to figure this out is to be on the lookout for more of these rocks as Perseverance drives away from Belva crater and ultimately out of Jezero crater. If Perseverance finds outcrops of Sita-like rocks there, that could flip the script on the birth of the ones inside Jezero. They may all have formed from ancient cataclysmic volcanic eruptions.